Transportation officials, advocates, companies, and users around the world are talking about how automated vehicles will change transportation as we know it. But what exactly are automated vehicles? There are two types of automated vehicles: autonomous vehicles, or AV, and connected automated vehicles, or CAV. An autonomous vehicle is a vehicle that relies entirely on its own onboard sensors for exercising vehicle control functions and maintaining situational awareness. A connected automated vehicle is an automated vehicle that has capabilities that allow it to be aware of other equipped vehicles in their immediate vicinity. It is also aware of the specific features of the surrounding infrastructure, such as intersections and curves. There are quite a few advantages to automated technologies. Safety. Driver actions account for more than 90% of motor vehicle crashes nationwide. Automated technologies minimize and can potentially remove human error behind the wheel, resulting in fewer crashes and fatalities. Mobility. Automated vehicle technology could result in greater efficiency and a dramatic reduction in congestion without the need for capacity. In Pennsylvania, congestion results in more than 264 million hours of delay each year. Land use. In an automated future, a vehicle could drop off one person, then pick up someone else, and be in almost constant use. That's unlike our current vehicles that sit idle for an average of 22 hours a day. In fact, some parking lots and garages could eventually be repurposed into green space. And society. Mature drivers and people with disabilities will be able to enjoy new transportation options and independence. In Pennsylvania alone, there are over 950,000 disabled citizens. Autonomous vehicles are split into six levels of automation, as defined by the Society of Automotive Engineers. 0, no automation. 1, driver assistance. 2, partial automation. 3, conditional automation. 4, high automation. And 5, full automation. Humans are responsible for motoring the vehicle and performing most functions in levels 1 and 2, while an automated driving system performs all functions in levels 3, 4, and 5. Vehicles in levels 3 and up are considered highly automated vehicles. As vehicles progress to higher levels of automation, less responsibility is put on the driver for monitoring the vehicle. Here's how an automated vehicle works. Several systems work in conjunction with each other to control an automated vehicle. Radar sensors dotted around the car monitor the position of vehicles nearby. Video cameras detect traffic lights, read road signs, and keep track of other vehicles, while also looking out for pedestrians and other obstacles. Light detection and ranging sensors, that is, LiDAR sensors, help to detect the edges of roads and identify lane markings by bouncing pulses of light off the car's surroundings. Ultrasonic sensors in the wheels can detect the position of curbs and other vehicles when parking. Finally, a central computer analyzes all the data from the various sensors to manipulate the steering, acceleration, and braking. Here's how connected technologies work. Connected vehicles are vehicles that use many different communication technologies to communicate with the driver, with other cars on the road, that is, vehicle-to-vehicle, or V2V, with roadside infrastructure, vehicle-to-infrastructure, or V2I, and with the cloud. This technology can be used to not only improve vehicle safety, but also to improve vehicle efficiency and commute times. With these technologies entering the transportation landscape, many stakeholders are looking at how to prepare. Pennsylvania and PennDOT, the State Department of Transportation, have been established as leaders in the realm of automated vehicles. The Pennsylvania Department of Transportation established the Pennsylvania Autonomous Vehicle Policy Task Force in June of 2016. The task force consists of government, academia, advocacy, and industry representatives. After several meetings and reviewing standards and feedback, the task force shared its final recommended testing guidance in December 2016. PennDOT and other task force members will continue to work with officials at all levels as guidance from policy and relevant legislation are implemented.
The future is bright, and it's very bright here in Pennsylvania. and we are intent on playing a major role in moving this very innovative technology forward.
These technologies will impact mobility not just in Pennsylvania, but also across the globe. We all have a role in preparing our communities for these monumental developments, and we welcome you to join us for this world-changing transportation evolution.